Hi everybody, I'm back, and today I want to show you all The Imaginary Forest by Jane F.Hankins. So I have had this book now for a little while. I got them with my with the tote bags, for those of you who have seen those. So I want to show you what's inside this. So this is one of her, it's not old, but it's one of the originals. Forget me. Published in 2018, so it is 2 years old. Anyways, the book is spiral bound. It has a soft cover, but it is still cardstock, so it is good enough. It contains 25 images, and it's on 80 grams paper or something, but it actually feels quite thicker or sturdy there. So let's open it up. So this is just the intro page with the Imaginary World logo, and here we found some info about Sebastian Press, which is the publisher. And then we just start right into the book. So we have this old the Forest King. That is who he is. Oh, and we have a pulse. Oh my god. Why? Come on. Stop. Let me see if I can. What is the, so this is the song. There is the autofocus, but should zoom you guys in at least some, like that maybe, but I can also lift the book up as we go, of course. Yeah, so this is the Forest King. He reminds me of one of those wizards in Tolkien's world, one of those tree wizards or a forest wizard. So this is the Forest King. I love him, and he has a little bird. I don't know if you are able to see that he actually has a, I should turn that off, a small little bird up in his hand. Look at that, that is just so cute. And he has trees as here and leaves, and we have a moon, or it can be a sun if you want it to be a daytime image. And also again that autofocus. Next page we have fancy ferns at the dewdrop ball. So there's the top of it. So we have some dewdrops up here on the leaves, and we have the ferns who have made themselves all pretty, and so they can go to the ball. We have a little snail down here hiding, and a little fern, or a young fern maybe there. So I love Jane's imagination, how she come up with these things. It's just amazing. It sure is a gift, and I'm so happy that she that she bring all of this to us. So here we have the Forest King again, or no, here we have the Forest Wizard and his cohorts. So yeah, so this is the Forest Wizard. Looks kind of like a king as well. But we have some small, or at least one, a little fairy and a little troll thing, and we have a little gnome or troll back there as well. Oh, beautiful. And he is all made of leaves. Oh, beautiful image. And I love that hat with leaves on it. The pages are perforated, so you can easily bend them and take them out, so you can parade them without ruining or cutting your book. So here we have a little girl. The sacred grove of the guardian trees. So here we have the guardian trees all around this little girl. So she's sitting there, and there is one of these forest gnomes looking at her. I love them. And we have a small, what looks like to be kind of a troll, or because of the hair, or she might be a fairy as well. And we have some smaller fairies like down here as well. Oh, they are so cute. And we have the guardian trees watching over her. Oh, I love this. And here we have time to put out our fairy lights. So all the fairies are flying around, well, not all of them, because we have some on the inside looking out as well. But we have this big tree with lots of fairies, and they're putting out the fairy lights. Oh, that is so cute. And look at that little guy. He is holding like a lamp post. And look at that little guy looking out. I'm so sorry. Look at that. Oh, come on, focus, you freak. Maybe now, come on, focus, please, come on. Oh, almost, you got caught. Oh, come on, camera, please. No, it doesn't want to. Jesus, I hate this camera. Anyways, we have lots of gnomes and cute stuff there. Next up, another tree with lots of fairies. So this book is suitable for all of those that actually loves fairies, because this has a lot of it. They are so cute. We have both fairy boys and fairy girls, and some looks like to be older fairies, or another type of fairies, or they can be tree trolls. Oh my god, look at this. Oh, the mushrooms, they are so happy. Even that little one down there is smiling and happy. And we have a little girl looking out, and that lives in that tree. But this has to be trolls for sure. So we have the mama troll, or it can be the father there. I guess it's hard to tell the gender on trolls. But there is that little baby, and we have a ladybug inside. We have another little girl. Oh my god, my lamp just fell. Come on. Another little girl surrounded, or sitting in the forest with the teddy trolls or something cute there. And we have a rabbit, we have some fairies, another fairy, and that fantasy creature, that fairy cat there, and trees and lots of fairies. That little troll up there is so adorable. Oh, I love them. At one point, I hope that we are getting a book with those small trolls all over it. Whee! Here they are flying in the wind. Awesome, awesome page. I can see this colored in autumn colors. I think I have seen somebody call it one time. So here we have this. Yeah, whatever it is, she is. She looks like to be a troll, but I guess that she is some kind of keeper, like a forest keeper, a guardian. And we have those teddies down here as well. She's holding a little boy and a little girl. And again, I love Jane's sons or moons. They always smile. And this one looks so cute. So it looks like to be like a, this can be a Norwegian troll as well. We have a lot of those here. And a teddy house. Get a new mushroom gnome other styles laden with gifts, including a new pet beetle. Oh, so she has a little pet beetle. Awesome. Get any comes and we'll be visiting the grannies. Mushroom gnomes are what these are called. Oh, and here we can see the house underneath the tree. This is awesome. So we have above ground here, mushroom in the entrance, and we see the tree going up here. And then we see what is underneath the ground. So we have the roots coming down, and they are living almost with a bedroom, and they're sitting having some dinner. And look at that caterpillar. So cute. So look. They have caterpillars in, or they use them as lamps. Maybe it is some kind of lightning bugs or something. Anyway, next up is the Merry Wood Witch. Oh, she is so happy and so jolly, and she just loves to dance. And, Laura at Anxiety Art Adventure just colored her. So if you want to see that, you should jump over on to Jane's YouTube channel, and you can see from the start to the beginning on how Laura has colored this. This is a Merry Wood Witch. And here we have again a tree with lots of fairies. Of course, this is the forest, so it will have a lot of trees and fairies. We have the fairy queen, what it looks like. On this special night, the pixie dust pods burst forth. So, looks like we have the fairy queen here, waving some kind of magical dust over the small fairies. Oh, such a cute image. I love it. The floatable fairy tree thrives on laughter. The more you giggle, the higher you float. This reminds me of a Mary Poppins, that Mary Poppins scene where they are laughing so much that they are floating. And the only chance of getting down on the floor again and not be floating up in the ceiling is actually to stop laughing. So this is awesome. Oh, I love this page. And of course I love Mary Poppins. So. What a wonderful mushroom house with this tiny little baby up in the window up there. This big ladybug mama with a small ladybug. And the small fairies living inside. Again, a big caterpillar and a smaller red bug. Looks actually like a tickle bug as well. And we have a mosquito. A skitter. Awesome. We have some beautiful birds. Oh, I love this. Oh my god. Can you imagine this one in bright, bright, happy colors? Birds on a feather flock together. Oh, they're beautiful. Lots of birds on a branch. Oh, and then we have this nosy birds. They are amazing. The nosy birds chattering about all the what does it say? Latest or something. Anyways, so they are chatting about, chatting and gossiping, all the nosy birds in this beautiful tree. Again, the imagination of having those noses on the birds and actually calling them nosy birds is just amazing. Oh my god. Look at this. Tree spirits. Oh, they are beautiful. I can't say anything else about them. Oh, and then we have a big teddy spirit, like one bigger one with a little gnome coming there, right? Troll of some kind. It's the wood nymph. It's texted there. Oh, which is beautiful. And here we have that little girl on another adventure with Nisel, the magical cat. So that is what the character is called. I think I need a list over what all of these creatures and things are called. I love that magical cat. It's like the Cheshire cat, just much cuter and not so scary. And yeah. And this looks kind of like was it Angelina? Actually, it was called. And I have this bunny with her. And I love those small creatures here as well. That was the three toppers, I think. And again, another teddy house. Or actually, we have several because we have some people or some bunnies living up there, and we have this creature. And bunnies and trolls, like a baby troll, and the father, and then the mother up there. We have birds, and someone is coming and visiting them. The house teddy. Yeah. Next up is this teddy. Dreaming tree. So we have the moon up here, I guess, and this dreaming tree is holding these two little children with the teddy bears. That is just too cute. And again, we have that awesome cat back there. I love him. And a lot of carries dancing beneath the tree of loving kindness. So this is the tree of loving kindness, and then she and her pet bunny is dancing under it. And here the fairies are coming and putting some dust over them. There is another little fairy here. That awesome cat. Look at this. Oh, I love this. This image is gorgeous. Oh, like I said, with everything. And I'm so sorry for that barking. This is just so awesome. We have a spotted unicorn. Oh, have you ever seen something like that? It's just amazing. I love it. And then we have the monkey thing. And something nosy. Yeah. Oh, and we have two children looking out there, looking at all these weird creatures. And look at those lips. Oh my god, that horse has some amazing lips. They will be red when I color this one. Teddy and Mr. Rabbity encounter the shy polka-dotted unicorn. Oh, it's a polka-dotted unicorn. And the aviary antlered thing deer. So this is a thing deer. Look at those antlers. They are with a lot of birds. So we'll have a close look at that deer. I call it a horse. I'm so sorry. It is a deer. Of course it is a deer. And this is a unicorn. A polka dotted unicorn. Oh, and that was it. That was the last image. And then we have the back page here. It's into the wood this time with a dream-like journey through the imaginary forest of Jane F.Hankins. So here you can see some of the images that is inside, and Sebastian Petter's info. Oh, I love this as well. Yeah, so that was The Imaginary Forest by Jane F.Hankins. I will link this book to, link this where you can get this book from her webpage. I will find the Facebook group where she also shares a freebie a month. So for those of you who wants that, you should jump over and join that so that you can get one freebie each month and color that. I will try if and I will find her Instagram account as well and link all of that underneath this video, so you will find it there. Thank you everybody so much for watching, and I will see you all later again. Have a wonderful summer. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.